Welcome back to ECMED TV. Our next guest is joining us all the way from France. Michel Drancourt is a professor at the Marseille University, specializing in tropical diseases, new microbes, all kinds of interesting things coming through. Nice to have you with us, sir, in the studio.
Nice to meet you. And so I think I'm coming from Marseille, and we are on the process of building a huge institute for infectious disease, tropical disease, which will combine both health, research, diagnosis, valorization, and teaching also.
Excellent. Now tell me about your journal, if you will. It's been an online journal for the last couple of years.
Right.
Are you promoting the journal here at ECMED?
Yes, I do. So it is a new journal. Its name is New Microbes and New Infection, and it has been launched 2 years ago in Berlin. And it is something which is very important for the society. So it is a companion journal of the CMI, held by Didier Raoult. And this online-only journal is clearly devoted to scientists from southern countries. And the idea is to offer a new audience for new facts in tropical disease, in new microbes, new technology for the diagnosis, and so on.
So you're publishing lots of papers in your journal on a continuous level?
Yes, that's right. Another peculiarity is that authors may publish in their own language, meaning that people
wow.
can publish in French, German, Spanish, Portuguese, Chinese, Arabic, and at the same time the paper will be translated in English so that everyone will be able to read the paper. But that's something which is very important and
that's
peculiar.
Terrific. Yes. What makes for a good paper? As the editor-in-chief, what are you most looking for when it comes to selecting the content?
Something new. A new fact. A true fact, of course, and a new fact. And so the idea, once again, is to promote new facts in one peculiar geographic area, meaning that you may discover antibiotic-resistant mechanism, for example, which is known already in other parts of Europe, but is new in Spain or new in Morocco or whatever. So that's the idea of this journal, you know, to promote something new in one peculiar geographic area.
Superb. Now, with my tropical diseases, I've been a port, a gateway for
We do have a long history of infection and tropical disease, even plague, for example, and low fever and so on. We had no longer disease in Marseille, but now we are exposed to a new infection, borreliosis.
Now, the Mediterranean Infection Division was
That's
establishment of the Mediterranean Infection.
Same institute and tropical disease, and at the same time the diagnosis. Basically, the idea is to be able to understand and fight because we do observe in stopping contagious infection, meaning that we expose epidemics. And we do think that we do know bugs, in fact, are an infected patient in the population. And so understand contagiousness and, of course, to again, contagiousness.
Seeing as emerging disease in your area of work?
We are looking at community-acquired infection and healthcare-associated infections now in Europe. We do know that, unfortunately, several thousand every year associated blood infection. And so we do have a peculiar program to fight against catheter blood infection, which is a deadly infection which could be stopped hopefully.
And you mentioned malaria a few moments ago. I mean, often, you know, you assume malaria from an outside point of view is typically an African disease.
Yeah.
As you say, Marseille is a port.
Yeah.
But if you're looking at malarial outbreaks or the possibility of malaria in France, I mean, that's a realistic observation, isn't it?
Well, it is not impossible. In fact, Europe had an history of malaria. In France, for example, a lot of people working to build the Versailles Castle.
Yes,
under
long time
the king.
Ago. Yes.
Yes, a long time ago. But there were a lot of malaria deaths in that time, just meaning that malaria was present in Europe until the Second World War, in fact. And so it's not so far from now. And so it is not impossible to think that malaria could be back in Europe sometimes. So we have to be very careful about this. And so studying vectors, insect vector, is something which is very, very important for the infectious disease.
Yes. And you're looking at from a journal point of view with new microbes and infections. Is this the kind of stuff that you parallel with your work at the university as well through the journal?
Yes, exactly. So the journal will offer a tribune for people studying, for example, the transmission of infection, including insect-borne infection. And it is really a good tribune for that.
How do people find out more about the journal? Where do they go online to get information?
Well, they can go directly online. And so now the journal is in the good venue that it is indexed in the PubMed Central, which is something very important for the author because it's a way to promote the work of people publishing in this journal.
Excellent. Now, you're here at the Congress, obviously, to talk about the journal, but also with your own interest in mind. I mean, this is ECCMID. This is the place where the world comes to share and gather information.
Sure.
What's the most exciting thing about ECCMID 2015 that you're interested in?
Well, I'm very interested in mycobacteria, so I'm looking in peculiar in this field, in these presentations. And I am also very interested in emerging bugs, emerging infections, so I'm looking also for this. And then a third point of peculiar interest for me is new technologies for the rapid diagnosis of infectious disease, including diagnosis in the point of care, meaning rapid diagnosis close to the patient. So I am very interested in these peculiar topics which are well presented here.
Excellent. Now, are you considering attending more lectures or networking? Where's your balance? Do you find a 50-50 or do you skew to one side or the other?
I would say one third and two third. I
mean, so one third attending the presentations?
Yeah.
And two thirds networking?
Yes, exactly.
Because this is where the world gathers.
Yes, exactly. So it is very important. And it is very important to look at the poster because young people are mostly presenting in posters, for example. So I think it is very important to look at this because it is maybe the future of the research and future of knowledge are maybe in the poster with young people, which is something very important, of course, for us.
Excellent. Professor, thank you very much indeed. Merci beaucoup, monsieur.
Thank you.
A real pleasure meeting you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thanks to you.